Hello, beautiful souls. Hope you're all well. Today, I wanted to talk about grief and its radical potential for transformation and healing. Generally, I think grief is an emotion that we try and stay clear of. We don't welcome it in. When it knocks on the door, we turn our backs away. Culturally, it is so easy to do this because there are so many distractions that can divert our awareness from it onto anything else, anything that captures our attention. And there's a lot of that. There's a lot that can capture our attention at our fingertips. And so we don't honor these sacred processes within our midst that needs to be embraced in order for us to heal and to live more fulfilling, creative lives. And so, what can trigger grief? So many things. The loss of a parent, the loss of a child, the loss of a pet, a loved one walking out of your life. A sense of loss, a sense of losing something or somebody that gave rise to a sense of joy and happiness, a sense of belonging or a sense of home within us. And now that they are gone, that sense is no more. And what is left in its place? But a lot of grief. And often it can feel like it's the end of the world. It can feel like one is a lost cause. It can feel like all is lost without this person. Whom gave rise to a sense of finding one's way home. It's very easy to fall in the trap of, this is how I feel now. I feel despair in me and I'm condemned to a whole life of misery. It's very easy for the mind to step into the process and to create trajectories, to create stories around our grief. But really, all that matters is being with the grief. Really welcoming it in through the front door, like you would greet a guest in your home. Offering it a tea, offering it a space to sit. Offering it a hug. Giving it the love and nurture it yearns for. Holding space, giving it the permission to be felt, and to cry. I think as well, culturally, especially within men, we're taught that crying is a negative emotion. I've seen it so many times where somebody is crying and somebody responds by saying, "Oh no, don't cry, it's all okay." But really, by just leaving them to their process of crying, holding space for them, you know, letting them know you're here for them, letting them know that it is safe for them to explore their emotions, that can give rise to a lot of healing in that person. It can help them to move through some struggles that they've faced so much of their lives. And it can give rise to a new beginning, new openings, new inspirations, new creativity to flourish on the other side. On the former side of the purge, of the grief, of the release, it can feel like a very arduous, treacherous experience that awaits the person whom is embarking on this journey. But then on the other side of the release, reaching deep, 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 deep into the core of one's being to pull out that sorrowful innocence that was repressed and was tainted by the culture that is so derailed from its roots, and to reach into that and to let it go, set it free to the winds to be blown away and the waters to clean, to wash away the pain. On the other side of that, beauty and joy. And so this arduous, treacherous, profound, and beautiful transformation is so sacred. So let us rejoice. Let us celebrate. Let us release the pain together. And let us come home. Let us come home to who we are. And let us embrace our blessings and our gifts and our creativity and our inspiration. Let us pick up the paintbrush or the guitar or the pencil. Let us channel that creativity. Let us express our feelings. Let us show what it is to be human. And so once the rubble of repression and despair and hopelessness and homelessness within ourselves, once that rubble is cleared, that flower that longs to blossom with all its beauty and its creativity is free to shine, to share its blessings and join this dance, this sacred divine play of creation.